And everybody knows what this is, right? A snake? No, it's not a snake. And it's not a worm. It's my albino eel. Now, as I'm only putting one end of it, but as the air is cooled down there, air moves from up the top down to the bottom. And that air keeps condensing. Only part of it's cold. Oh, okay. It just keeps getting smaller and smaller. Now, all the air that was in those balloons is still in those balloons. All of it is still there, so as I take it out, you might be able to see down at the bottom there's some liquid splashing around. That's liquid air. And that air is warming up, turning back into a gas, and as it does, cool, not just cool, 77 degrees K. As soon as that warms up. Now, some of my other buddies here. If we're lucky, they will all come back. Without popping. How long does it take to make ice cream? hour. How long does it take? It takes approximately forever when you want that ice cream, right? Well, we don't have an hour here. We have a very short time. You want to move back to the... Okay. Outside, there's hot deli hot dogs, and you guys can have some ice cream as well.
And we're not supposed to have food in here, but our volunteer does get to taste our ice cream first.
Yeah, you want food at work?
You know, she survives, and you can have some later.
How much more?
Done all these experiments with the kids. There's one that there's several, the next series, that I've not done, but it's the first of them is one that you're gonna all have to help me with. We want the Mess With Your Mind up on the screen. And the firefighters who are here for the next part of the show, you guys come down and get ready for the part. Now, when you get this image up on the screen, you know, I forgot. We worked so hard on getting the video camera working, and we never use it. Can we go back to the video camera? Is it working?
Oh, let's see.
Over here, I have on the table a disc of semiconductor, and I have a camera looking at it.
Okay, you want a light up there?
Here.
And you can see that disc of semiconductor. A superconductor, and this is a tiny magnet. That superconductor is only superconducting when it is at liquid nitrogen temperatures or below. So I'm going to pour some on it, and you can see it boil there. What's happening now is it's boiling. When it becomes superconductive, there is no loss of electrical energy. None at all. It has zero resistance. When that happens, the magnetic field will induce a current in the superconductor. That current will make a magnetic field of its own, and as it does, it will repel the magnet, and so that magnet will levitate. While we're waiting for that to happen, I'm going to spill a little bit of this stuff out here. Now, what you're going to see is it looks like water. I mean, it doesn't quite behave like water, guys, normally. Now, if it comes off the stage, don't touch it. That looks like water on a very, very hot skillet. fact, that process, I think that's starting to levitate. That process is called Liebenfrost, and it was investigated back in the time of Benjamin Franklin by a fellow in Europe. You see that magnet is now floating? And if I pick it up, I can put it back right where it was. Just hanging there in space. You're looking at quantum effects. Okay. Now, I don't know how it happened, but in the course of getting ready for this, do you want to help me with this, get this out of the way here?
He's good.
Yes, yes.
We had a little disagreement, and in the course of it, I somehow managed to offend him greatly. He challenged me to a duel.
What do you mean I challenged you to a duel? I haven't done that yet.
Throw down the gauntlet.
He wore a blue shirt. I wanted him to wear red. Didn't that offend you?
Anyhow, since he challenged me, I get to choose the weapons. I have over here one of our weapons. John, you've got...
You got the best.
We need lights on the stage.
Not to be outdone. Normally you'd stand back to back and walk 10 paces and turn and shoot, but turning and shooting with those things is not easy, so. Can you take your glasses?
Put it on one of them, then wear them right now. That's good.
If you're going to duel, you have to duel safely. Let's put the video up. Keep watching it. Don't let your eyes wander from it. Don't let your eyes wander. Don't look around. You might see that it starts to behave a little strangely around it, but don't look over there. Keep looking at the center. Keep looking there. And now that it's firmly implanted in your brain, think about that. What I would like you to do is turn and look at the, when I say so, turn and look at the person beside you or look at your own hand. Ready, set, now. Did I mess with your brain? Sisters, I want to come up here.
Me!
Yeah. No, I've already picked them out. I've already picked them out. Okay. I just need three. I'm sorry about that. I want you two to stand over here. And you to come and stand over here. Now, I'm going to explain a chemical reaction that we're going to do. That chemical reaction involves iron and oxygen. Okay, here's iron and oxygen.